group options, presenting the benefits of individual sessions, packages, and programs, agreeing with concerns, not overcoming objections. Very important part of your strategy. Okay? John, you want to lose the weight, don't you?
Yes.
Okay. Did you want to lose muscle or did you want to lose body fat?
Body.
Okay. That's how the whole game is played. I'm asking questions. It's all coming back from him. Okay? I'm doing it in the form of alternate choice. And I'm utilizing the right vocabulary, and I'm agreeing with whatever concern he has. If you say, I've got to talk it over with my wife, you say, of course you do. I would expect you to do that. Most of my clients do the same thing. And if Manny says, well, I got to look at my budget, of course you do. It's not like a contest of he says A, so I say B, so it becomes a tennis match. Whatever his objection is really just a concern. And if I'm coming from the right place, his concern is my concern, because we're on the same side of the table. You want to get in the best shape possible at the most affordable price as quickly as possible. Am I right? That was another question, wasn't it? We could do this all day, couldn't we? It's fun to ask questions instead of making statements. Am I right? Okay. So very, very important is that you get out of your mind that when one of your prospects says, I have to discuss it with my wife, I have a checkup coming with my doctor, I can't make a decision till then, I always have to sleep on it, I have to look at my budget, I'm going on vacation next week, all of that's fine. But then you keep going. You agree with the concern and you keep moving forward. You don't say, yes, you can afford it, give up the nachos. You say, if I could find a way within your existing budget where you don't have to come up with any new money to be able to invest in a custom fitness program, you'd probably be excited about that, wouldn't you? Because you do want a custom program, don't you, Adam? Okay, and we love asking questions, don't we? That was another one, wasn't it? Okay, so that's what your job is. Your job is to not overcome their objection, but agree with their concern and move forward, okay? Coaching clients, a qualitative experience associated with superior trainers. What I found that the 7 Habits of Highly Effective Personal Trainers are, they are, Lynn talks about health and fitness professional, they're success coaches. They are truly success coaches. When you're a great personal trainer, you're working on mind, body, spirit, you're working on their budget, you're working on their future, you're working on their parenting, you're working about how effective they are at their job, you're working on how they avoid the doctor's office, all those things. You're making them better for the rest of their life. So you're a success coach. That's how big I want you to think. Because if you sell yourself on that, then you'll never question the money. Have you ever gone to a doctor and asked him, Dr. Smith, how much do you charge for a chest x-ray? Oh, $75? I got a Groupon. I could get that chest x-ray for $50 down the road. Has that conversation ever happened, folks?
A Groupon.
Exactly. It's ludicrous. So when people are getting into a price conversation about your personal trainer and charge $30, I could get it for $22.50. This is not a movie ticket where, if you go to a matinee, you should save. They should be perceiving you like